It is a joy to see young scholars on their way to broaden their minds.
If I'm honest, I wish I had something to boast about. But I'm hopeless at everything. Oh! I suppose that's something to boast about.
Who lived here, I wonder? She wasn't making it up. Well, we've come this far. Miss Willardsey might get an answer about these butterflies. Goodfinger! What we have here. Lumos.
Protego!
Confringo!
Confringo!
Incendio!
Production! No! Yes! Neon Fringo!
take it.
Would that you all wielded that power for good.
Confringo!
I would say that Iredale is not appropriate.
Contago! Levioso!
Is this your best?
Confringo!
I heard. Stop right there!
Protego! Stupid fucker!
Nothing for one luck!
Depulso!
Thank you. Potato!
Stupid one! Stupid one!
Repulsor! Taking pace, Zanbakar's tower. Lovely view, I'd imagine. No idea who this Bakar is, mind you.
Over here.
We're not alone.
We are not. Ranrock's loyalists. Around a dozen, I can see, but could be more.
Can't we apparate past them into the tower?
We could, but we've no idea what's in the tower. More importantly, however, I'd like to know why they're here. They've set up camp just ahead. I suggest we investigate a little before doing anything else. Let's go.
Well, this isn't ideal.
No, it isn't. This way. And I'd suggest we use the disillusionment charm here. No sense in announcing our arrival. Quickly now. Stay hidden and cast Petrificus Totalus.
There must be something here. Ramrock said so.
Stupid. No! Potato! No!
Rather unwise coming back this way.
Orders. Directly from Ranrock.
These orders indicate that they're after something to do with names. What names? And why here? Goblins have always been antagonistic towards wizard kind, but this is different somehow. Oh, I'm glad that's over. Best head inside.
It's more than mere coincidence that we encountered Ranrock's loyalists here.
Looks like we've found the entrance.
It's locked. An unlocking charm.
Very handy. No time now, but if you don't learn it soon enough, we can work on it back at the castle.
Someone was an avid reader. Can't say I'm familiar with many of these titles.
Welcome to San Bakar's Tower.
Hello, Professor. Did you say San Bakar's Tower?
I did. Professor Bakar is a keeper you have yet to encounter. I'm glad to see that I was correct in presuming that we would meet again soon after our last encounter. Though I surmise, based on the commotion I heard, that you did not have an easy time getting to me.
We did not, Professor. We encountered goblins outside the tower.
That goblins were aware of my vault is disquieting enough. But if they have also made a connection to this tower, then the threat may be greater than I thought. All the more reason for us to move forward. Downstairs, near the entry, a reservoir of ancient magic, like those you've seen before, has been unlocked. Commanded to access a doorway. I'm afraid I cannot say more. As Professor Fig cannot join you, he and I will, in time, see you back at the map chamber. Remember what you see.
We're going to need to understand how Ranrock's loyalists knew about a tower that once belonged to a keeper. For the moment, however, you've more important things to set your mind to. A reservoir of ancient magic, I believe?
Yes, sir.
Then I shall leave matters in your increasingly capable hands. That said, be careful.
I will, sir. I'll see you back in the map chamber. A reservoir of ancient magic, downstairs, near the entry. I've seen this before, in Gringotts and the Restricted Section.
Thank you.
I presume I'm looking for traces of ancient magic. But where? Must have done something. Best have a look around. traces of ancient magic. Something must be different. They're never a welcome sight. At least I know what to expect this time.
Protego!
Stupid one!
These look familiar.
Akio!
What did that burst of magic do? Perhaps I should examine things from both sides of the archway. The room changes when I move in and out of the archway. I can see a way out on one side, but when I pass through the archway, it's blocked by a wall. More statues. What did that burst of magic change on both sides of the archway? Something must be different. Seems I ought to explore this archway from both sides.
Here.
need to see how the room changes when I move in and out of the archway. So that's it. I need to use both sides of the archway to get the platform to the other side of the bridge.
Accio!
So that's it. I need to use both sides of the archway to get the platform to the other side of the bridge.
Accio!
So that's it. I need to use both sides of the archway to get the platform to the other side of the bridge.
Accio!
So that's it. I need to use both sides of the archway to get the platform to the other side of the bridge.
Accio!
I'll never get used to these floors.
Akio.
Now to see what's changed on each side of this archway. Things are definitely different on either side of the arch. But how?
Rebellion.
I don't know. What a relief. Another pensive.
Your ability to transfigure the world around you is remarkable. What is it?
My father isn't getting better. I don't think he'll ever recover from the death of my brother.
It is agonizing to see those we love suffer.
The drought was years ago. The pain of losing him is as deep for him now as if it had happened only yesterday. He doesn't need pretty pillars, he needs peace. What if I could help him, Professor?
You do so much for your father already.
It's not enough. I want to take away his pain.
It is tempting, I know, to use this magic that you're mastering to transfigure more than the physical world. But human emotion is a potent force unto itself. Even the most well-meaning and competent witch cannot possibly know the consequences of irrevocably manipulating it.
So I'm to watch as my father's pain destroys him.
It is not your pain to take. Every year, a student sees something sillier than I could ever imagine in their tea leaves. Oh, Miss Morganach, welcome back to Hogwarts, Professor.
That's going to take some getting used to. Mm. Professor Rickwood?
I was so pleased to hear that you'd accepted the position of Defense Against the Dark Arts, Professor.
Sit, sit, Isadora. Tell us about your travels.
I was actually hoping that you and the others might join me at my home this evening. There's much I'd like to share with you.
That would be delightful. We shall let the others know.
Very well. I shall see you then.
Another memory. Now to find a way out of here. More crystallized stone. That must be the way back to the map chamber.
What have we here?
I'm a student at Hogwarts, sir. And this is Professor Fig.
Professor Charles Rookwood at your service. Has someone completed the first trial?
I have, Professor Rookwood. We saw you in the Pensieve in Gringotts with Professor Rackham.
Indeed. So, you found the portkey to access Professor Rackham's vault, and you deciphered the map within the locket you found floating above that Pensieve.
I did. I found something that I can't identify floating above the last Pensieve.
Ah, yes. You will find a similar artifact in each trial. You must take care to keep them safe. You will need them to complete the journey we have set forth for you. Once you have them all, we will tell you what to do with them.
Very well. Are you able to tell me anything about the next trial?
Before you proceed, I would like to speak with Charles regarding the urgent situation involving the goblins.
The goblins?
The student has seen traces of a powerful dark magic being wielded by goblin kind. They and their mentor, Professor Fig, not only encountered goblins lurking outside of San Bakar's tower, they also encountered a powerful goblin in my vault at Gringotts.
I'm afraid it would be wise to halt the trials until we know more.
We shall defer to you in this matter, of course. Now then...
Wait, Professor, the name Rookwood, do you think...
That there's a connection to Victor? Perhaps, but we can't be sure of its significance, if any. For now, tell me what you saw in the Pensieve.
Before the witch from the last Pensieve, Isadora, became a Hogwarts professor, she argued with Professor Rackham about using magic to remove pain.
Hopefully the next Pensieve provides more context. For now, we should learn what Ranrock knows. I will be honest, I've no idea where to start.
Actually, I might know of someone. I saw Serona at the Three Broomsticks speaking to a goblin once. They seemed friendly.
Well, it's worth a try. See what you can find out. Of course, don't forget...
My studies. Yes, sir.
Before you go...
Professor?
Have you encountered swirling traces of magic in the world? Aside from those along our path?
Not that I recall. What are they?
Evidence of the Keeper's efforts to manipulate the power of ancient magic during our time. If I am correct, and I usually am, you should be able to use them to inform and enhance your own magic.
Thank you, sir. I will look out for them. I should ask Sir...
Come and see me about a pressing and highly confidential matter at your earliest convenience. I believe that we may be able to help each other.
Can't imagine how inconvenient travel was before.
I'll see me after class once you have completed the tasks I've set for you. I would like to teach you descendo, useful for pulling objects to the ground.
Coming up with clever passwords day in, day out. Not as easy as it looks.
Thank you.
What are you up to now?
Hello there. Nice to see you. Folks still talk about you taking down that pole in the village circle. You certainly made an impression.
Hello, Miss Willardsey.
Well, what happened? Did you find them?
They led me into the forest and revealed a treasure.
Oh, how lovely! I'm glad you were rewarded for your efforts. Perhaps one day I'll be able to bring myself to go into the forest. For now, I'm happy simply knowing there's something so lovely to see, should I dare.
Hello, Miss Ryan. I wanted to thank you again for your help with Rookwood and Harlow the day of the troll attack.
Serona, please. And I was happy to help. Oh, those two are nothing but trouble. Glad you and your friend were here when they found you.
I am too. You were speaking to a goblin here that day.
Yes, Lodgok. He's a friend.
It seems as though you were on good terms with him.
I've known him for years. We met when I was waiting tables here as a student, well before I bought the place. He was cordial enough, but we weren't friends then. His mistrust of wizard kind ran deep.
But you're friends now?
We are. I hadn't seen him in years when he came in a few months ago. But he recognized me instantly, which is more than I can say for some of my own classmates. Took them a second to realize I was actually a witch, not a wizard. Not all goblins are like Ranrok and his loyalists. Lodgok is as worried as the rest of us about what's been going on.
In that case, I'd like to talk with him, about Ranrok in particular. Where might I find him?
I assume your interest is to do with the rumors I've heard about Ranrok working with our friend Rookwood.
It is.
If he's not here, you might find him doing business at the Hog's Head. He's a trusted metal trader. You should mention that we spoke. He can, understandably, be wary of witches and wizards, even ones as young as you. That said, if you're looking for information on Ranrok to help rein him in, you'll find an ally in Lodgok.
Have you heard what Ranrok and Rookwood are working on together?
Not much more than the fact that they seem to have some sort of uneasy alliance. Friendship between wizards and goblins is rare enough, but between those two, they each want something the other has. I can guarantee it. That said, I fear they're like a two-headed serpent. Both will need to be taken down to stop whatever scheme they've been plotting.
Thank you, Serona.
If you find Lodgok, please give him my best. I don't know what you've done to make such powerful enemies, but please, watch your back.
You too, Amit.
Welcome to the Hog's Head. Any empty seat is yours.
You
You look familiar.
Hello, Lord Gok. Sirona said I might find you here.
She did she? Did she send you with news?
No, actually, I wanted to speak with you. It's about Ranrok.
Now I remember. The three broomsticks. Day of the troll attack. You're the student he's after.
I am. And I need to know what he and his loyalists are up to, so I can stay a step ahead.
Let's say I did know. Why should I trust you?
Sirona trusts me, and she thought our interests may be aligned.
Well, if Sirona trusts you, very well. I may know of something that could help us both. A way to get Ranrok to confide his plans to me.
I'm listening.
Years ago, a heinous witch stole a sacred goblin relic. Rumor has it that it now rests in her sarcophagus, in a tomb accessible only by wizard kind. Ranrok and I had a falling out a while back. The relic could well repair the chasm between us.
Very well. I'll retrieve the relic if you promise to share Ranrok's plans with me.
We will have to trust each other. I, that you will not abscond with the relic, and you, that I'll share what I learn. Gather whatever supplies you may need and meet me near the witch's tomb.
I'm ready.
Good. There's no time to lose.
What precisely is the relic I'm to retrieve?
A valuable heirloom known as the Helmet of Urtgot. The witch considered herself a collector and purchased the helmet as a trinket. She cared not what pain she caused the goblins. Goblins believe that the rightful owner of any object is its maker, not its purchaser.
Wizard kind see things differently. It's a wonder goblins and wizards have ever been able to work together.
The differences between our kinds are myriad.
They seem to be.
It may surprise you to know that I do not believe those differences always to be insurmountable. It is the reason I find myself traveling with you to this tomb today. Ah, and there it is. The witch's tomb.
Dreadful looking place, isn't it?
I wish you luck retrieving the helmet. As a wand carrier, you should have an advantage. Now, before you set off, do you have any questions?
What about this helmet makes it so special?
The helmet of Urtgot is an ancient and storied relic, forged during a time of unity among the goblin clans. It inspired greatness, that is, until it was no longer ours. Then it became something else. A symbol of what has been lost, of all that wizardkind has taken from us. Reclaiming it would mean a great deal to goblinkind and to Ranrok. He would be grateful to me should I return it.
It all seems clear to me now that we're here.
I do hope our alliance proves fruitful. Again, I wish you luck. I will remain here, eagerly awaiting your return. Please, be careful.
Lumos. It's sealed. Moths. Curious. Merlin's beard. Lumos. This can't be the witch's tomb. Likely I need to go further.
Also!
Lumos! Thank you. Lumos. Lumos. I have a feeling I'm not alone here. Lumos. If I could power it somehow, it looks like it could be rotated. Protego! Lumos. Thank you. What's that hanging there? Looks precarious.
Depulsor!
I go. No other way.
Oh!
Lumos, Protego! Can break up.
Lumos.
Revelio.
Looks even more complex. Thank you. Lumos. Making this spin ought to raise that platform. That must be it. Bring moths to the door.
Lumos. 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 Revelio. Lumos.
Revelio. Revelio. Revelio.
Lumos. The witch's final resting place. Lodgok said the helmet was in her sarcophagus. Dead Ashwinder. Your compatriots must have made off with the helmet. Lord Gok won't like this. Better show this to Lord Gok. I know there's a mechanism to open this door. Lord Gok, the sarcophagus had been raided. I found no helmet, only a dead Ashwinder.
Damn! They got here first! We need to get it before Rookwood uses it to further ingratiate himself to Ranrok. I saw one of their campsites not far from here, but I fear you must go in alone. My fighting days are behind me.
I'll head there now.
Good. There's no time to lose. Get to that helmet before Rookwood does, or we will lose our chance at any leverage, no matter how small, with Ranrok. To think those wretched thieves have their hands on such a relic.
This place has seen better days. There they are, the Ashwinders.
You will not survive this.
Expulso!
Potato!
Rebellion. It.
This is for Rookwood!
A lamb to the slaughter.
Depulsor.
Let's see what you make of my
Confringo. Protego.
No one!
Lady Osa!
I'm embarrassed for you!
The pulse!
Novice to that!
Revelio.
Wonder if I'm safe to explore in there. I retrieve the helmet from the Ashwinders.
Well done! This is sure to impress Ranrock.
The helmet shines even more brightly than I imagined. The etchings, the contour of the profile, remarkable.
It looks stunning, Lodgok. I see why you wanted it back.
You did the thieves a service by recovering it. I know many a goblin who would have killed for it.
Ah, then I am glad to be rid of it myself.
Thank you. This should earn Ranrock's trust. I will take it to him immediately. It may distract him from his search.
His search?
It is merely an inkling. You have impressed me greatly, friend. I am glad that I trusted you. We shall speak soon. Best to keep our arrangement quiet for now. Many will not believe that our aims might possibly be aligned.
Does it get any more cozy than Hogsmeade?
Beetle the Bard is a bit too hairy-hearted for my taste. Not enough to collect them.
Thank you.
Welcome, everyone. I see you've already met some of the many beasts we study in this class. Though be advised, none of these creatures should be taken lightly. They are all in their own way dangerous, especially if one does not know how to handle them properly. Now, it seems many of you are out of practice. Let's take some time to review the basics of how to care for a beast, shall we? Miss Sweeting, would you please assist our new student with the lesson today?
Yes, Professor Howen. Hello, I'm Poppy, Poppy Sweeting. Don't worry about Professor Howen's speech. She over-exaggerates sometimes. All the beasts in class are perfectly safe. Oh!
Miss Sweeting, pay attention, please. The tongue of a puffskin can be a slippery devil.
Yes, Professor. Here, you can practice on Gerald. Just keep an eye out for his tongue. You can use my brush. Just be gentle. Oh, and think pleasant thoughts. I like to think it enriches his experience. That's lovely. I'm sure he feels much better. I think he might be hungry. Would you mind giving him some beast feed? What do you suppose the pellets taste like to Gerald? Pudding, I like to think. I think we can safely say that Gerald likes you.
That's good news. He seems very nice.
He is. Kindness is one of his best qualities, right after ambition. And cleanliness.
Good work, everyone. Now, let's make our way to the pens and select another beast. And please, do be careful as you feed and groom them. Miss Sweeting, why don't you show our new student to the Neasels in the farthest pen?
This way. The Neasels are over here.
Oh, couple of Neasel whiskers ought to get me a few canuts at least. Enough to buy something from Honeydukes. Stupid thing.
What in Merlin's name are you doing?
Tuss tuss, peculiar Poppy. Worried about a worthless little rodent.
Her name is Persephone!
Her name is Persephone!
That's really not funny. Let's go.
Those two don't belong anywhere near this class. Poachers in training. Persephone was onto them instantly. Thank you for your help. Let's carry on. Feed and brush the Neasels just as you did with Gerald. The Neasels really took to you. They know a good egg when they see one. As do I.
It appears our time has come to an end. Please close the pens and...
Where are the lions?
Now, where is our new student?
A happy beast is a giving beast. That's what Professor Howen always says, at least. If we treat them well, they'll treat us well.
Hello, Professor. You wanted to speak with me?
I did. How did you find your first beast's lesson?
It was wonderful. I believe I'm really going to enjoy this class.
Good. You seem to understand that when beasts are properly controlled, they can play a vital role in our lives. Some provide us with magically imbued materials. if cared for correctly, which does not include torturing them for whiskers. Well done, by the way. Probably best to let me handle it next time.
Yes, Professor.
They're nearly as bad as the savagers in Rookwood's poacher pack. Sadly, we're the ones who suffer, stumbling over dead beasts. Terrible waste of resources.
Surely the poachers can be brought to justice by someone. The Ministry, perhaps?
An optimistic idea. Now, why don't we focus on more immediate matters that we can control? Professor Weasley has asked that I prepare some assignments designed to help you catch up to the other 5th years. Be on the lookout for my owl. Meanwhile, I also encourage you to study as many beasts as you can on your own time.
I need to talk to you. Come here.
Do you need something, Poppy?
Thank you again for saying something to those brutes so that I didn't have to. You were an augury at noon in the desert.
I certainly hope that's a good thing.
It's something my gran and I say. It means that something or someone is a welcome surprise. At least, that's what we decided it meant.
I couldn't stand there and watch them harm the poor thing.
We're of a similar mind. Actually, in light of that, there's someone I'd like you to meet in the forest.
You've intrigued me. Very well. Lead the way.
I'd hoped I would. Come with me. I wouldn't take just anyone there. In fact, you're the first.
Really? Well, thank you, I think.
As I said, we think alike. Pleasant surprise. Quite the weather we're having, don't you think?
Poppy, where are you taking me?
It really is much better if I just show you. Don't worry, we're nearly there. It's just ahead. Stand back. Magnificent. Go on, introduce yourself to her. But be careful. You must always show hippogriffs the proper courtesy before you approach them. Seen a hippogriff take to someone this quickly. You can feed and brush her if you'd like. I come and check on her every once in a while. Bring her pasties, tell her what's going on in the castle. You wouldn't know from looking at her, but she's a dreadful busybody. What did you think of Highwing?
I thought she was brilliant. Can't believe you introduced me to her.
I suspected you two might get along.
Are you the reason students have been seeing hippogriffs flying above the Forbidden Forest?
Perhaps. Did you know that once you earn a hippogriff's trust, they'll always be there for you? I've seen it firsthand with her.
How exactly did you and Highwing cross paths?
It's a longer story, but I rescued her from poachers a few years back. Got her to safety and, well, she was fine until recently. You may have noticed that poachers are something of a problem in the area, so I worry they could get her again. And I might not be there next time.
Professor Howen mentioned the poachers as well. She seemed to imply that we couldn't rely on the Ministry to help.
I don't often agree with Professor Howen, but on that, I fear she's right. The poachers' influence is growing. I see them every day in the village, lingering, talking to people. They're up to something. I'm just not sure what.
You may be reading into it. Talking to people isn't a crime.
It's hard to explain, but something about it just feels wrong. I think I'm going to look into it. Find out what's going on, what they're doing.
I think that's a fine idea. Information is power.
And the more I know, the better I can keep Highwing safe.
You seem undeterred. Will you let me know what you find out?
Oh, very well. I will. I should be going, but we'll speak again soon, I hope.
Thank you.
The tiles. Some of them can be most potent.
Hello again, Mr. Moon.
Oh, I was hoping to see you again, my young friend. Gladwin Moon, Hogwarts caretaker, at your service. First, please allow me to apologize if I seemed a bit, unsteady when we last met. I'm afraid I had a rather disconcerting encounter. Although I hear your visit to Hogsmeade was even more eventful than mine.
I suppose you could call it eventful. I certainly wasn't expecting a troll attack.
Oh, of course not! And from what I understand, the village was lucky you were there. In fact, my recent visit to Hogsmeade is the reason I was hoping to bump into you. I could use your help with something. Do you see that curious statue over there? Watch what happens when that light changes from day to night. We are fortunate to have a student. Now, if you wouldn't mind humoring me for a moment, see if you can remove the moon from the statue. Go on, take the moon. Odd little contraptions, aren't they? It seems the statue vanishes once the moon is removed. Which, incidentally, can only be done at night. Why don't you hold on to that one for now, and I'll explain more as we walk. Ever since that fateful day in the village, those curious statues have begun appearing about the castle. A fair number have been strewn around Hogsmeade. Someone, it seems, is trying to torment me. You see, that day in Hogsmeade, I turned a corner and came face to face with a boggart, or shapeshifter, if you will, which takes the form of whatever scares you most. This one took the form of a demiguise.
A demiguise?
Yes! Terrifying creature that can see the future. Wholly unnerving. I encountered one when I was a lad in Korea. Terrible experience. Those statues are demiguises. The moons, I assume, are an uninspired play on my name. Some jackanapes used a boggart to learn my greatest fear and use it against me. I have my suspicion as to the scoundrel or scoundrels responsible. It is my hope that they will slip up and reveal themselves as the statues disappear. That is why I need your help in removing the statues.
Why me?
A couple of reasons, frankly. First, your daring do against those trolls in Hogsmeade has gained you a reputation for fearlessness. Second, as macabre and hideous as a demiguise is, most would find my fear of them unwarranted. You, however, have seen how they affect me. I'm at my wit's end, young friend. I simply can't bring myself to go near them. In fact, I know of two statues right here in the faculty tower. Perhaps you could start simply by removing them so I can go about my evening duties.
The faculty tower. I'm not sure I should be going in there.
Oh, you needn't worry. You'll be perfectly fine if you simply mind you're not seen. First, you know how to cast a disillusionment charm, correct? You'll want to do that before wandering the tower at night. Next, you'll notice that the door is locked. However will you get in? Alohomora, that's how.
But what about curfew?
You? Oh, tosh! I sense you're a bit like me when I was your age. Oh, the school was my oyster. And I took advantage of it. Oh, everyone loved me for it. Oh, those were the days. Now, you'll find one statue in the prefect's bathroom and the other in the hospital wing. Good luck. Oh, and thank you.
Thank you.